Hi friends, this is Preeti. So today I'm going to discuss about sympathomimetics. In my previous video, I have discussed about receptors associated with the sympathetic nervous system and the synthesis and degradation of the neurotransmitter involved in the sympathetic nervous system. So now we'll study about the drugs which act on that receptors. Okay. Normally, the drugs acting on these sympathetic receptors are of two types, sympathomimetics and sympatholytics. Sympathomimetics are also called as adrenergic receptor agonist. It means they mimic the action of the norepinephrine. Okay. Whereas sympatholytics means adrenergic receptor antagonist. What these drugs do, they block the action of these agonistic drugs. Okay, they prevent the agonistic from binding to the receptor. So first we'll study about the classification. The first classification is based on the mechanism of action. These are of three types: directly acting, indirectly acting, and mixed acting. So first we'll study about directly acting drugs. Directly acting drugs are again divided into phenethylamines and imidazolines based on the structure. Okay. Phenethylamines means it contains a benzene ring and a ethanol. This is ethanol, CH2CHOH, and amide, NH2. And then imidazoline means 1,3 nitrogen 5 membered ring. Okay, this phenethylamine is again divided into catecholamines and non-catecholamines. Okay, catechol means it consists of catecholine, non-catechol means they do not have any catechol ring structure. Okay. So, these catecholamines examples are dopamine, epinephrine, norepinephrine, methyldopa, dobutamine, and isoprenaline. Okay, all these compounds have a catechol ring. So, here we can see. So, the structures of this main drugs I have given. Dopamine means benzene, catechol ring, CH2CH2, NH2. Whereas, epinephrine means on this beta carbon will have a hydroxy group, and CH2 and NH CH3. Okay, whereas in norepinephrine we do not have this methyl group. Okay, in name itself it is there, norepinephrine. Okay, from epinephrine if we remove this methyl group we get norepinephrine. So the structures of all these drugs, the remaining drugs, I will add a clip after this slide. Okay, and here under non-catecholamines we have salbutamol, terbutaline, bitarterol, and phenylephrine. Okay, they will have beta hydroxy group but they do not have any catechol ring. Okay, and another class is imidazolines. Okay, this is imidazoline, oxymetazoline, xylometazoline, nefazoline, and clonidine. So they do not have a catechol ring and also beta hydroxy group. And next we come to the indirectly acting drugs. Indirectly acting, directly acting means they directly act on the alpha or beta receptors. Okay. Indirectly acting means these drugs, they show their action without acting on receptors. Okay. It means, for example, if we take tyramine drug. So tyramine is, it is a precursor for this norepinephrine. So it increases the synthesis of norepinephrine. So here what is happening, it is not directly acting on the alpha or beta receptor, but instead it is increasing the synthesis of norepinephrine. Whereas if we take amphetamine, what this amphetamine does, it inhibits the MAO, monoamino oxidase, and also norepinephrine transporter. Okay, so then what happens, there is an increase in norepinephrine in the synapse. Okay, then the increased norepinephrine, it acts on the receptors. Okay, so these drugs are nothing but they do not directly act on the receptor, instead they increase the concentration of this norepinephrine by various mechanisms. Okay, and here the drugs are hydroxyamphetamine, pseudoephedrine, phenylhexedrine, and these are the examples. Okay, these drugs contain a common structure, phenpropanolamine. So here you can see, here it is a phenethylamine. So if we add one more carbon, we get phenpropanolamine. Okay, there is no catechol ring in this structure, but we have a beta hydroxy group. And if we come to mixed acting, these drugs act by both direct and indirect. Okay, examples: ephedrine, mephenteramine, and metaraminol. So in these drugs, there is an absence of catechol and also absence of beta hydroxy except metaraminol. So except metaraminol, the remaining drugs have no catechol ring and also beta hydroxy group. So catechol ring is present only in catecholamines. In dopamine, epinephrine, norepinephrine, methyldopa, dobutamine, and isoprenaline. So this is the classification which is based on the mechanism of action. Okay. Next, we'll go to the classification based on receptors. Okay, we have alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1, beta 2. The drugs acting both on alpha and beta, and finally dopamine. Okay, if we come to the alpha 1, so the drugs acting on alpha 1 receptor are phenylephrine, methoxamine, ephedrine, mephenteramine, and oxymetazoline. So there is no explanation in this, just we have to remember all the drugs with their respective receptor. Okay, so now we'll study about the therapeutic classification. So this classification we can write easily if we are thorough with the receptors and with their location and function. Okay, so now we'll study about the first class. First class is nothing but vasopressors or pressor agents or antihypertensive. It means the drugs under this class causes the contraction of the blood vessel and they increase the hypertension. Okay. So, blood vessel means on blood vessel there are alpha 1 and beta 2 receptors. Okay. On the alpha 1 receptor, if the norepinephrine acts, the resulting action is smooth muscle contraction. Whereas on beta 2, the resulting action is smooth muscle relaxation. So we'll use only alpha 1 drugs under this class. Okay, I think you have understood. So that's why I have written alpha 1 agonist. Okay, all the alpha 1 agonist plus noradrenaline, because this noradrenaline is both alpha and beta. And then dopamine. Okay, all these drugs comes under antihypertensive agents. Next class, it is bronchodilators. Okay, bronchodilators means it is related to the lungs. On lungs, which type of receptors are present? Beta 2. That's why all beta 2 agonist and isoprenaline. Okay, isoprenaline is also called as proterenol. Okay, so these drugs comes under bronchodilators. Okay, they cause bronchodilation. And then CNS stimulants. Under this class, we use indirectly acting drugs. Nothing but amphetamine, dexamphetamine, and methamphetamine. Okay. These drugs are independent on the action of receptors. Okay. They will not directly act on the receptors. Instead, they increase the production of this norepinephrine. Okay. These are the indirectly acting drugs which comes under CNS stimulants. Next, we come to cardiac stimulants. Cardiac means heart. So on heart, which type of drugs receptors are present? Beta 1. So all beta 1 drugs comes under cardiac stimulants. Okay. So all beta 1 agonist plus adrenaline and isoprenaline. Okay. And next, nasal decongestants. Under this class, we have oral and topical. Under oral, we have phenylephrine and pseudoephedrine, whereas under topical, all imidazolines, oxymetazoline, xylometazoline, nafazoline. Okay, all zolines, all imidazolines, topical. And the next class is vesicoselective, also called as uterine relaxants and vasodilators. Okay, So, uterine relaxants. First of all, uterus means it is a smooth muscle. So, on smooth muscle, two types of receptors are present. Alpha 1 and beta 2. Similar to that of blood vessel. Okay, blood vessel is also smooth muscle. So, now alpha 1 and beta 2 are present. Alpha 1 causes smooth muscle contraction and beta 1 causes smooth muscle beta 2 causes smooth muscle relaxation. But here vasoselective means uterine relaxation. The drugs are causing relaxation of the uterus. So we use beta 2 drugs. So all beta 2 agonist. Okay, all beta 2 agonist comes under vasoselective. Nothing but uterine relaxants and vasodilators. Okay. And the next class is under this beta 2 agonist, we also have ritardrin and isoxaprin. Okay, beta 2 agonist include salbutamol, which is also called as albuterol, and terbutaline. All these are beta 2 agonist, and also we have ritardrin and isoxaprin. And next we have appetite suppressants or anorectics. Okay, here we also have appetite stimulants, which are called as orexia. Okay, like that we have uterine stimulants and uterine suppressants. Okay, uterine stimulants means ecbolics or abortifacients, and whereas uterine relaxants means tocolytics. Okay, like this we have so many synonyms for this drugs. So if you want to get more number of these type of clips, just follow my Instagram page. So the link will be in the description. So now we come to appetite suppressants. Under this we have fenpropanolamines, fenfluramine, dexflunfuramine, fluoxetine and sibutramine. So these three drugs, fenfluramine, dexflunfuramine, these act on serotonin receptors. Okay, whereas sibutramine act on both adrenergic and serotonin receptors. Okay, so this is nothing but the therapeutic classification. So now we have completed three types of classifications. The first one is based on the mechanism of action, and the second one is based on the receptors, and the third one is based on the therapeutic therapeutic effect. Okay, get into the uses. So if we are perfect with the classification, the therapeutic classification and the receptor classification and the receptor location and function, then we can write the uses very easily. So if we come to the alpha 1 agonistic drugs, uses of alpha 1 agonistic drugs, as the alpha 1 receptors are present on smooth muscle, eye, liver, so these drugs are used to treat the disorders with respect to these organs, with respect to these locations. Okay, it means alpha 1 receptors are present on eye, and the function is, when norepinephrine acts on alpha 1 receptors, the function is midriasis. Dilation, it means we can treat glaucoma. Okay, and then on smooth muscle, it's showing contraction. It means we can treat the hypotension. Okay, we can treat the hypotension. And then in liver, it is showing gluconeogenesis. Okay, like this, we have to remember the uses. And if we come to alpha 2 receptors, they are present on platelets, presynaptic neuron, pancreas and eye. So these are also present on eye, and also they reduce the aqueous humor formation. So these drugs are also used to treat glaucoma, but the mechanism is different. Here they are reducing the aqueous humor formation, but alpha 1 drugs are they are causing the dilation. Okay, so the mechanism of action is different, but the use is the same. They are used to treat glaucoma. Whereas these drugs, by acting on presynaptic neuron, they are inhibiting the production of these norepinephrine. So these also can be used in hypertension. These can be used in hypertension. Okay. Norepinephrine causes the contraction of the blood vessel. So by inhibiting the production of that, we are causing the relaxation. So we can treat the hypertension. These are antihypertensive drugs. And then on pancreas, they will cause a decreased insulin secretion. Means we can use these drugs in insulin shock. And then on platelets, they cause platelet aggregation. It means they decrease the bleeding. Then we can, it means that we can use these drugs in hemorrhage. Okay. So these are the uses of alpha 2. Next, if we come to beta 1, these are present on heart and kidney. Heart means they cause an increase of force of contraction. It means there is an increase in BP and there is an increase in cardiac output. So these are also antihypertensive agents. Okay, they are used to treat hypertension. And then increase in force of contraction means these drugs can also be used in congestive heart failure. Okay, beta 1 drugs. Also cardiac stimulants. And then if you come to juxtaglomerular cells of kidney, they increase the renin release and angiotensin, and then they are finally increasing the BP. So these are mainly used as cardiac stimulants. And then if we come to beta 2, they are present on lungs. So they are causing bronchodilation. It means they are used in the treatment of asthma. Okay, the disorder related to lungs is asthma. Whereas in a smooth muscle, they are causing relaxation. It means these drugs we can use in hypertension. In high BP, if we give this drug, it causes the relaxation of the blood pressure, the relaxation of the blood vessel, and there is a decrease in the BP. Okay, and then these are also present on mast cells, and they cause a decrease in histamine release. It means we can use it as an anti-allergic drug also. So these beta drugs we can use in the treatment of asthma, and we can use in the treating the hypertension, and these are also anti-allergic. And then if we come to beta 3, these are used to break down the fats. Okay, these are used in lipolysis. And now we'll study about the adverse effects and contraindications. So normally there are two types of concentration: minimum effective concentration and maximum therapeutic concentration, or minimum toxic concentration. Okay, minimum effective concentration means the concentration at which the drug shows the therapeutic effect. And then maximum therapeutic concentration or minimum toxic concentration means the concentration of the drug at which it shows the unwanted side effects or adverse effects. Adrenaline in subcutaneous or intramuscular injection form, there can be a irregular heartbeat, which are nothing but palpitations and anxiety, and also tremors. Okay, involuntary muscle contractions. Okay. So normally if we take any drug to the intravenous administration or intramuscular, there will be a faster action, because as the drug is directly going into the bloodstream, it will give a fast action. So if there is any overdosage of the drug, then it may lead to these adverse effects. Okay, and also it may cause a rise in BP. So as this drug causes, adrenaline causes smooth muscle contraction by acting on the alpha 1 receptors, the blood vessel contracts and there is an increase in the blood pressure, and it may lead to cerebral hemorrhage and also ventricular tachycardia, means increase in heartbeat. Okay, these all things will happen. And this adrenaline is contraindicated in hypertensive and angina patients, because normally its use is to cause a hypertension. If again we give the same the drug to the patients having hypertension, what happens? It may lead to the rupture of the blood vessels. So this drug should be contraindicated in the patient suffering with hypertension. Okay, and also it should not be given during anesthesia with the drug halothane. If we give this drug with the halothane, it may cause arrhythmias. Okay, there is a risk of arrhythmias. And then it should also be contraindicated in the patients receiving with beta blockers. okay. Beta blockers like propranolol, all this we will give to the patients decrease the BP. Okay. If suddenly we again give this adrenaline, there can be a marked rise in the BP. Okay, there is a sudden rise in the BP. So it is also very danger. Oh, please like, share, subscribe and comment the video. Thank you so much for watching my video. We'll meet in our next video.